Also PhD. Dr. Glynis Mendon, also PhD. So, 30,000 words in 3 minutes. 60,000 words, kitle 90,000 words?
For how many?
Your thesis must be at least 60,000-80,000 words.
Words, no. Pages, sang maka.
Pages, 300.
Pages, no. Close to
400.
350.
Words. So, 3.5 minutes. Give us a sum. I know I'm being very unfair to you, but tell us in 3.5, and whatever time, take your time, not an issue. Tell us about your thesis.
No. What is your point? Noise will not come in the background.
You don't worry. We'll make more noise than them. Come on, speak loudly.
So, mache in Konkani or English?
English. Mix,
okay,
whatever.
My thesis is titled Kokani Fiction in English Translation, a Critical Study. I took around 4 years to complete this work. This work is about Kokani fiction, wherein I have defined fiction as narratives in prose, which comprise of novels, novellas and short stories.
Which ones?
Which have been translated into English till 2013. Till 2013, that's the year I registered.
There are not too many, no?
There weren't many. So, the first thing that I did is I went to the archives of the library, of Central Library. That's the best library I found. And I went through all the newspapers, whichever were there. You know, it took me a couple of days. And I documented all the works which have been translated. The Kokani which I took was only in Devanagari, okay, not in Romi or in the other scripts like Parso Arabic. And you know, Kokani is written in 5 scripts. I have only referred to Nagari novels which have been translated into English up to 2030. So the novels which have been translated till then were Mahabaleshwar Sells Houghton as The Kill, Mauzo's Carmeline as Carmeline, Kali Ganga as Kali Ganga by Mahabaleshwar Sail, The Kiln again by Mahabaleshwar Sail, and Pundalik Naik's The Upheaval, which is a translation of Achev by all, most of them were by Vidyapai, except there was a novel Tsunami Simon which had just come the year I registered.
Xavier Cotta's translation
of Tsunami Mauzo. Simon. Namazan and Mauzo. I think it's a novella for youth. It's on the brink of a novella and just on that borderline. It's for youth. It's a youth fiction category.
So there were just 5 at that time?
Yes, I took. And for a thesis, you require at least 4 to 5. But then I also took short stories. Now, the short stories which were in translation, I got from Manohar Shetty's...
Goa Today.
He was doing it when he was the editor in the early, late 90s and... You know, and then he came up with this Penguin published Fairy Crossing.
Correct.
There were a few stories there. Now, the ones which were rejected by him from Fairy Crossing, he came up with this Goapuri issue called The Harvest, which was titled after one of the stories. I took from him because the first thing I went to his house 2-3 times and he gave me the copy of The Harvest. And then I counter checked it. It was a Goapuri issue which he had renamed as The Harvest. And there were a couple of... So, these were my 2 basic texts because the others were all scattered.
Very interesting.
Yeah. So, these were the 2 complete published
there's
texts.
So little work done on...
So, there was little work.
And no, after there's little work done on translation. There's even less work done on understanding translation. Would
understanding
that be right?
Translation. Yeah. So, I worked on... Actually, my thesis, you know, Ben Antao gave a review to my thesis when it was uploaded. He says, Glennis, he says, your work... He wrote to me. He says, this should have been 2 theses. You know, like 2 PhDs you can do out of this one. And that's why it has gone up to close to 400 pages. Because I did it at 2 levels. One is understanding translation by taking these as examples. Okay, the entire nitty-gritty of translation using theories of translation. And the other, I have taken these texts and used them from critical lenses. Feminism, eco-criticism and subaltern studies. So I've used 4 theoretic perspectives. One is translation studies, feminism, eco-criticism and subaltern studies. PhD before this erstwhile has been done on Kokani fiction in English translation. This is the first time. I'm very fortunate to be guided by Dr. Kiran Purpule, who's well-versed with both the languages and now, right now she's retired and she even served on the Bakipa Borkar chair which was attached to the Kokani department, and it was a wonderful working under her. So my thesis is available online.
The full thesis?
Yeah, the full thesis is available.
And what's your conclusion? I mean, what are you?
My conclusion is that there is very little work done. There's lots that needs to be done. And after I put across this and started talking about it, a couple of other novels came. I also felt that women novelists and fiction writers were not translated. And that's why I wrote a very powerful essay for Selma's first book, which was published, the journal, you know, João Roque journal, which came as a published text. So that in that I wrote about women, amplifying women's voices as fiction writers, particularly in English translation, because no novel was translated. And by the way, the first novel which I found in the archives was a translation of Hema Naik's Bogdan, which was not published as a full text because the translator expired.
Who's that?
Thali.
Prakash Thali. Translated as what? Bogdan as?
As Bogdan.
English?
English.
When you talk of translations, Glynis, you're talking only Konkani to English or English to Konkani? Which is more important and why?
English to Konkani is, I would feel,
not that
important, because Konkani audiences, majority of them can also read in English.
But the other way doesn't work.
Because Goans have an English
multilingual
thing. But the other way doesn't work. Because if you want a Konkani novel, especially in Nagri or Umi, or
you
whatever,
can't access it.
You want it to win a thing like Sahitya Academy Award, or you want it to win some kind of an award at a national level or international level.
Or even
level.
Get noticed internationally.
Yeah,
it cannot be read.
It cannot be read if it doesn't have a work in translation.
But
Sahitya Academy especially.
We don't have a big enough base of translators, so how do we break through this vicious cycle?
So we have to get camps of translators into working. We need to have mobilize a whole team of translators. We need to have more translation camps. We need to have more translation workshops. We need to tell people that this is a career which is so beautiful and can be so lucrative.
You're able to initiate something at the college level?
Yes,
because you teach at
Yes,
Kamal's.
Because there is a paper called, a skill-based paper called Translation Studies. There are papers
we have
introduced. I was in the Board of Studies. I've just concluded my term. And we have introduced those papers. And we have motivated students to take this as a skill-based course. There's a, you know, skill enhancement, SEC course paper, wherein translation is a part of this academic syllabus. So I think there is a lot of scope. And if the love for translation, I never knew this domain was so enticing and interesting. And once I've worked in it, I've found it, very captivating. And I have started translating. One of the things which Prema asked me for my Viva was that, since you know so much about the insides of translation, you know, the kind of theoretic ideas and the whole, you know, what is fidelity, felicity in translation, what is the different aspects of translation, wherein I've kind of looked at translation theories and things like that. Why don't you translate yourself? And I took it up seriously. At that time, I fumbled. But then I said I have to take it. And I started translating short stories and things like that. Novel is a big challenge because I'm working full-time in a college. But I think it is a good go for people who are looking at a career which is, you know, which is interesting and rewarding as well. Of course, it's a thankless job at times,
it is.
But at the same time, it is
thankless
quite
and time-consuming. Yeah,
time-consuming. But at the same time, it is very captivating and interesting. And I think we need to give it a thought
Thanks.
And a go.
Thanks so much and all the very best.
Yeah, thank you so much, Rico.